Hello students, last time we have explained about BE products. Today we are going to explain next topic, BE diseases and BE enemies. So first we'll explain the BE diseases. Honeybees are one of the important industrial insects which are also infected and affected by various bee diseases. Both the adults and the brood or young ones of the honeybees are attacked or infected by numerous bacteria, fungi, protozoan, mites, etc., and leading into a partial or the total loss of the honeybee colonies. Most of the bee diseases are infectious and spread very quickly like jungle fire in the colonies. In case of adult bee diseases, the worker bees are the main sufferers. So among the adults, workers are the main sufferers of the bee diseases. Serious infections cause decrease in a number of workers and thereby affecting colony strength or reducing the number of bees in the honeybee colony. In the brood diseases, that is the young ones, that is larvae, pupae, will also get infected or attacked by number of pathogens and leading into the brood diseases. The larvae are killed and get decomposed. The gross symptoms of the adult bee diseases are the same regardless of the causative agents, and a proper diagnosis is possible only with the help of microscopic examinations. It is observed that sick bees are generally unable to fly and can only hop about the hive, and others crawl on the ground, bottom board, entrance board, and also climb on blades of the grass. The hind wings are unhooked from the front wings or fore wings, and the abdomen is often quivering and distended, which looks shiny or greasy. So these are the some of the important symptoms of the diseases found among the adult bees or the sick bees. So first we'll explain protozoan disease, namely Nosema disease. Nosema disease or a protozoan disease, it is caused by a protozoan belonging to class Sporozoa, and the genus species is Nosema apis. So Nosema apis is a protozoan parasite causing the protozoan disease or the Nosema disease in the adult bees. It was first detected in 1974 in Uttar Pradesh, which attacks lining of the stomach and small intestine and causes dysentery in the adults. The spores of this pathogen are passed out with the feces of the infected bees, and when eaten up by the worker bees while cleaning the combs, and thus the disease mostly attacking the adult bees in a winter season when they do not go out, and quickly reduce the number of bees in the colony. Stomach and small intestine of infected bees become dull grayish white as compared to the brownish red or yellowish of healthy bees. So these are the some of the symptoms of the Nosema disease. So the causative agent or the pathogen is a protozoan parasite called as Nosema apis, and it attacks the lining of the stomach and intestine and causes the symptoms of the dysentery in the adult bees. So the infection of the adult bees occurs through the spores of this pathogen, which are passing out with the feces of the infected bees. And when these are eaten up, when the spores of the pathogen are eaten up by the worker bees while cleaning the combs or while cleaning activities. This disease mostly attacking the adult bees in a winter season, during which usually the bees, all the members of the colony lives in the colony, and this will thus reduce the number of bees population among the colony due to the Nasema disease. Stomach and intestine of the infected bees become dull grayish or white as compared to the brownish red or yellowish of the healthy bees. So this is about the Nasema disease or the protozoan disease and causing the dysentery or a Nasema disease in the adult bees and reducing the population or the strength of the adult bees of the honeybee colony. The microscopic examinations reveals that the spores reflect light and have glistening appearance. So this disease is more common in a temperate regions than in the tropical countries. To control the disease, Nasema disease, the following treatments are recommended. That is, first, sterilization of brood boxes, sterilization or the disinfection of brood boxes and the frame hives with a glacial acetic acid fumes. Glacial acetic acid fumes. For this purpose, the cotton soaked in the glacial acetic acid and these cotton rags are kept in the hive box on the bottom board so as to apply the fumes of the glacial acetic acid in the hive box. Or 40% formalin fumes only after the queen and the bees have been transferred to new foundation seeds. So 40% formalin fumes can also be employed for the sterilization or the disinfection of the protozoan spores from the colony so as to produce the disease free condition in the colony. Then second disease called as amoebic disease. This is also a protozoan disease caused by Malpig amoeba Medifici, which infest the Malpighian tubules of the adult bees. The cysts of amoebae are passed into the intestine from where it comes out of the body with the feces and to infect the other bees as they clean the feces from the combs. It also produces dysentery type of symptoms and can be treated in the same way as that of Nasema disease. So amoebic disease is another protozoan disease caused due to protozoan Malpig amoeba Medifici and which is infesting the Malpighian tubules, that is excretory organs of the adult bees, and it also produces the symptoms of the dysentery similar to the Nasema disease and can be controlled by same way as that of Nasema disease. Then we'll explain brood diseases. The brood means developing stages, that is larvae pupae, which are in the stage of development in the brood comb or in the frames of the brood comb or in the brood chamber, and thus the diseases are called as a brood diseases. So diseases which are found among the larvae and pupae, that is the young or developing stages of the life cycle of the honeybees, are called as a brood. So the brood, that is larvae and pupae, also suffer or get infected by number of pathogens and leading into different brood diseases. The brood is attacked by various bacteria, fungi and filtrable viruses which take a heavy toll or the loss. The general symptoms of the brood disease are discoloration of the larvae, dark cappings, punctured and sunken cappings, irregular brood, that is many empty cells are scattered on the comb or in the brood comb, and there are five brood diseases. There are five type of brood diseases. So among which we'll explain some important brood diseases. The first one, that is American fowl brood disease. So among the brood diseases, there are various type of brood diseases, that is bacterial disease, fungal disease, viral disease, etc. And this will also cause much of the loss or heavy toll or loss of the larvae and pupae from the brood chamber or the brood one. So the general symptoms of the brood diseases are discoloration of larvae, that is darkening of the larvae. The general symptoms of the brood diseases are discoloration of the larvae, that is darkening of the larvae, then dark cappings, punctured and sunken cappings, irregular brood, that is many empty cells are scattered on the comb, that is broodlessness, that is also explained as a broodlessness, means there are many empty cells found in the brood comb due to the death of the larvae in the several cells due to the attack or infection of the pathogens causing variety of brood diseases. There are five brood diseases. So first we'll explain American fowl brood disease. It is the most serious and important disease of the brood or a larvae and very difficult to control once it attacks an apiary. The American fowl brood disease is caused by a bacterium, Bacillus larvae white. So it is pathogen, bacterium, type of bacteria, that is Bacillus larvae white, causes American fowl brood disease. So this is the bacterial disease and is caused due to the attack or infection of Bacillus larvae white type of bacterium into the larvae. The disease spreads quickly and the apiary may be wiped out completely. The disease is introduced into the hive in the form of spores in the honey, on combs bearing pieces of the infected bees, or through the used beekeeping equipments from some previously established source of infection. So the disease is introduced into the hive through the contaminated honey or honey or pollen or the food which is contaminated with the spores of the bacteria of Bacillus larvae white, causing the infection and leading into the symptoms of the American fowl brood disease. So this results into many empty cells found in the brood comb due to the death of several larvae, or the larvae which are died off due to the bacterial disease, American fowl brood disease, caused due to Bacillus larvae white. The symptoms of the brood are sunken and perforated cappings of the sealed brood. The symptoms of the brood disease are sunken and perforated cappings of the sealed brood comb, which appears irregular, open, and the punctured cell. So this is what the conditions occurring or appears in the brood comb, that is sunken or perforated or punctured cappings, then which appears irregular, open, and punctured cells, and many of the cells will not show the larvae in the cells. So many empty cells appears due to the death of the larvae in the brood comb. So this results into a fowl brood. Fowl brood means many empty cells appears due to lack of larvae, developing larvae in them. So this is the diagram showing bacterial disease, American fowl brood disease. So there are many empty cells, black colored cells, hexagonal cells, which are empty without brood or without larvae, and only the certain cells, few number of cells, which are closed or sealed with a wax cappings, with a intact wax cappings enclosing the developing larvae inside. So many black colored cells, open cells, or punctured cells appears onto the brood comb, showing the fowl brood That is, many empty cells are seen onto the comb due to the death of the larvae caused due to the bacterial disease called American foul brooder disease. So this is the image showing American foul brooder disease in the comb. The spores of the bacterium, that is Bacillus larvae white, are fed in the brood food or feed by the nurse bees, that is either bee bread or the royal jelly, whatever the feed fed to the larvae or the brood by the nurse bees, which is contaminated with the spores of the bacterium Bacillus larvae white, which breaks up the stomach into the body cavity, rapidly proliferating and subsequently killing the larva. Larva then rots and turn chocolate brown and then black in color, and finally it dries. Later change into a ropey or a sticky slimy mesh producing a foul smell. So these are the conditions occurring in the infected larvae or in the brood cells which the larvae are infected due to the bacterial spores, which are infected through the contaminated feed, that is either pollen, honey or royal jelly, which is contaminated with spores of the bacterium Bacillus larvae white, causing the infection of the larvae. These infected larvae or the spores, when getting entry into the gut of the larvae, that breaks up the spores of the bacterium, or the bacteria breaks up the stomach wall and releases outside into the body cavity, then undergoing its rapid multiplication or proliferation, and subsequently leads into the death of the larvae. Then the dead larvae rots, turns chocolate brown color, and then become black, and finally it dries, and later change into a ropey or a sticky slimy mesh producing a foul smell. The percentage of the dead brood is from 1 to 75%. The percentage of the dead brood or dead larvae is ranging from 1 to 75% in a bacterial disease, that is American foul brood disease. In mild infection, the disease can be controlled by dusting the combs with a sulfathiazole powder. In severe infection, the standard method used in USA, that is to kill the infested colonies and burn the bees, combs, hive and hive parts. Though efforts continue to evolve, resistant strain of the bees are being made. Its appearance in India is greatly dangerous for wild migrating colonies of the three species of the bees, would spread the disease like a jungle fire, and the industry may be wiped out completely, and this disease is not common in the tropical countries. So this bacterial disease is found only in the temperate regions, and in mild infection or in a mild infection or the mild case, the disease can be controlled by dusting the combs with a use of sulfathiazole powder. Dusting of the sulfathiazole powder as a pesticide can be dusted, or powder of which can be dusted to control the disease, that is American foul brood disease. But in severe infection, the standard method used in USA, that is to kill the infested colonies and burn the bees, combs, hive and hive parts. Though efforts continue to evolve, resistant strain of bees are being made. Its appearance in India is greatly dangerous. In India, the occurrence of the American foul brood disease is dangerous for wild migrating colonies of the three species of the bees, and would spread the disease like a jungle fire. And the industry, that is apiary or beekeeping industry, may be wiped out. The disease is not common This disease is not common in tropical countries. So this is about the American fowl brood disease, that is a bacterial disease caused due to the larvae, that is Bacillus larvae white. Then second brood disease called as Chuck brood disease. It is a fungal disease. It is caused by a fungus, Pericystis apis. The spores of this fungus enter in the gut of the larvae, where they germinate and leads to form the fungal molds like strands, which penetrate the body, finally resulting into the death of larvae. In short, spores of this fungus converts larvae into a chalk white masses of the mycelium. So it is a fungal disease. The chalk brood disease is a fungal disease, and it is caused due to a pathogen or the fungus Pericystis apis. So the mode of infection is the spores of the fungus Pericystis apis enter in the gut of the larvae, where they germinate and leads into the development of fungal molds or the strands, which then penetrate from the gut into the body cavity and finally resulting into the death of larvae. In short, spores of this fungus converts larvae into a chalk white masses of the mycelium, that is fungal molds, which grows inside and outside of the dead larvae, and this result into the larvae like a chalk white hard structures. Chalk white or chalk brood is called as a chalk brood because of formation of hard dead brood or the larvae because of growth of fungal mycelia or fungal mold inside and outside of the dead larvae. So this result into chalk like structure. If bees remove cappings of the cell, the larvae are rubber like. If bees remove cappings of the cell, the larvae are rubber like. Later they shrink, become tough and loose in the cells. Normally the bees themselves are able to keep this disease under control, but in severe case the combs should be destroyed and the bees must be transferred to a clean hive. Dampness and poor ventilation. Dampness, that is a high humidity condition near the hives or the honeybee colonies, that is a dampness, and a poor ventilation are the main cause of the infestation of the chalk brood disease. So chalk brood disease is a fungal disease and is caused due to Pericystis apis. So the spores of this fungus get entry into the gut through the contaminated food, and which germinate, the fungal spores germinate into the gut and producing fungal mold or the fungal strands, which penetrates out the body cavity and cause the death of larvae, and after which they penetrates out the body wall and develops the white chalky fungal mold or mycelia all around the body of dead larvae, and this appears similar to the chalk like structure or chalk white hard larvae, dead larvae, called as chalk brood disease. So usually if bees remove cappings of the cell, the larvae are rubber like. Later they shrink, become tough and loose in the cells. Normally the bees themselves are able or capable to keep this disease under control, but in severe case the combs should be destroyed and the bees must be transferred to a clean hive box. The dampness and the poor ventilation are the main cause of the infestation of this disease. Then third type of disease, that is the chalk brood disease. It is caused by a filterable virus. This disease is spread in a colonies due to drifting of or the movement of nurse bees. The diagnostic characters of the sac brood disease is as follows. Larvae infected just before the capping. Larvae infected just before the capping. Usually what happens after feeding of the grub or the larvae of the honeybee in the respective brood cells in the later phase of the larval development, that is on 5th or 6th day of the larval development, the brood comb or the larvae developing in the respective brood cells are closed or sealed up by the wax cappings. So, before which there is a infection of the virus, filterable virus, which get entry into the larvae through the feed, that is either royal jelly, bee bread pollen or honey contaminated with the viral infections. So, it is caused by filterable virus, and this disease is spread in colonies due to drifting of the nurse bees. While taking care of the brood, the nurse bees or the workers which are moving about the brood comb, causing the infection of the filterable virus in the larvae. The diagnostic characters of the sac brood disease are larvae infected just before the capping. The dead larvae usually found in a sunken capped cells. The dead larvae usually found in a sunken capped cells. The larvae are dirty white to black in color. The dead larvae become dirty white in color or black in color with a black head. Whole larvae may be pulled out from the cells like a sack of water. Generally, there is no odor. In brief, the larvae become sac-like. In short, the larvae become sac-like with a tough skin and die after being fully grown inside the capped cells. Due to its peculiar form, this disease is called as Chinese stiffer disease. Due to its peculiar form, like a sac-like form, it is called as a Chinese stiffer disease. Maintenance of strong colonies, better management practices, and re-queening of weak colonies are the preventive measures or methods to avoid the infection of this disease. So, viral disease, filterable virus, which enters the larvae, leading into the death of the larvae, and while or in a advancement or in a progressed stage of the disease, sac brood disease, the larvae become discolored or become black in color. First they become dirty white in color, then become black with a black head, and whole larvae may be pulled out from the cells, can be pulled out from the cells like a sack of water. Like a sack of water means the interior dead tissues or internal dead tissues of the dead larvae get hydrolyzed into a watery fluid, but body wall remains intact. The body wall of the larvae, dead larvae, remains intact like a sack and filled up with the water. So, this can be pulled out from the brood comb like a sack of water, and thus is called as a sac brood disease. So, it is caused due to a filterable virus, and infection occurs due to the drifting of the nurse bees. Maintenance of strong colonies, better management practices, and re-queening of the weak colonies are the preventive measures to avoid the infection of this disease. So, this is about the various brood diseases. So, with this, that is brood diseases, so we have explained two adult diseases such as the Nosema disease and the amoebic disease. Nosema or the protozoan disease and the amoebic disease, which are commonly found or occurring in the adult bees. and the brood diseases. Among the brood diseases, we have explained three examples of the brood diseases, such as one bacterial disease, that is American fowl brood disease. Then second, that is a fungal disease called as Chuck brood disease. And third, the viral disease called as Sac brood disease. So all the three type of pathogens, that is bacterial, fungal and viral infections, leads into these three type of brood diseases and causing the death of larvae and thus reducing the strength of the honeybees or the honeybee colonies due to the death of much number of the larvae due to these brood diseases. Next time we will continue with the enemies of the honeybees. So with this, today we will stop here. Thank you.